Yo, what is up guys, Guido here, back again with another video. And in this video, I'm gonna show you guys how to install a horn. On your mini bike. So let's just get straight into this video. So I highly, highly recommend you guys install a horn on your mini bike because let's just be honest, downright, it just looks badass. And also for safety, these things are only about maybe 2 feet wide and 4 feet long. They are pretty, pretty tiny. And being known when you're riding these things is pretty important. That's why it's nice to have a loud exhaust so people know that you're coming. So having a horn is very, very beneficial because I've had people cut me off before where they didn't see me because it's so small. And having that horn is very, very nice that you can just beep, beep, toot it when they're coming. So basically, it's a big thing for safety, and I'm gonna be trying to get these bikes actually street legal as they are right now. They're street legal, if you wanna put it in that term, as I have lights, turn signals, use your hands, mirrors, and now the horn. But you know, they're not fully street legal, if that makes sense. So basically, we're just gonna be doing a full video on how to install these, and we're gonna be installing them on mini bikes, but this will also work for dirt bikes, quads, side-by-sides, UTVs, whatever, as it's gonna be the same basic, you know, steps on how to basically wire it. But like I said, it's gonna be kinda more specific for mini bikes. And these are the Monster Moto 80-105 frames with Predator 212s on them, just so you can kinda get the whole sizing, you know, down of where you have space to put it. So let's just get straight into the video. Now, basically with the horn, you kinda have to decide on your bike where you wanna mount it. Now every bike's gonna be different, and this video is gonna be more specific to the Monster Moto 80-105 frame with the Predator 212 in it. So like I said, it's gonna be different, but you gotta find a spot of where you wanna mount it. So as you can see on my dad's bike, how he mounted it there and basically bent the bracket and mounted it on the handlebar mount there. But another location is right here. You could mount it into here. You'd have to drill that out a little bit bigger. But you could definitely mount it there. You could mount it, you know, somewhere on your handlebars, under the seat, or wherever. So basically, you just gotta find a spot where you wanna mount your horn. So as you can see, that's where my dad mounted his, and this is where I mounted mine. Basically, just cut the bracket and mounted it on the motor right there. And I think it looks really nice and sleek, and it's kinda under there. It isn't, you know, too out. But mind, when you are doing this, make sure it kinda is forward facing and it is somewhat out, because if you mount it underneath the seat facing this way or down below or wherever, the noise is kinda go that way. So you kinda want it to be going forward because that's where the bike is traveling. So keep that in mind, and that's basically where I mounted mine. So now this is basically gonna work for honestly anything, mini bikes, dirt bikes, quads, side by side. It's kinda all the same process of just wiring and a horn, but it's gonna be specific to mini bikes. So this is basically the kit that I got. That basically kind of comes with everything, you know, your button, your fuse, relay, everything. So this is kind of something I recommend you guys have, because as you can see how my dad's is routed, he's got his button here for the horn, which is perfect. Try to make it, you know, somewhat on the handlebar, so when you're riding and you need to slam on the horn, it's quickly boom, 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 you know, accessible with your fingers and stuff to press it, or even somewhere over here. Just kind of don't have it down here where you got to reach down and press the horn, because it's kind of more of a necessity thing that could possibly save your life on one of these things, because they're small enough. So definitely it's recommended to have a horn on these things just because they're so small. You kind of want to be out there and known when you're riding, or in case something does happen, it's good to use it. So this is basically what came in the kit. It looks confusing because it's just kind of a lot of wires, but it's really nothing too crazy. Basically, here is your relay. And it basically goes all the way to the wires. You got your wire for your ground here to hook up to your battery, and then also you have your positive to hook up to your battery along with the fuse. So, and then this is the button for the actual horn to that connects and stuff, so you can actually press it and activate the horn. So, you know, it's kind of pretty self-explanatory with how stuff goes and hooks up and stuff like that. But also mind, when you're doing something like this, you are gonna have to have a battery on your bike, side-by-side, motorcycle, whatever. You can't really do anything of like a rechargeable like drill battery or anything, unless you can try to hook it up some other way. But I recommend just getting a 12 volt motorcycle battery like what we have down here and up there, which powers my lights and my stereo system. So click in the top right if you want to see how to and make a mini bike light kit along with installing a battery. It's in the top right and in the description below. And also look in the description if you want to know how to install a mini bike stereo system on your bike as well. I highly recommend, especially if you're doing this on a mini bike, get a dirt bike stand or something, or put it on like the upper level of your backyard or something so you can work on it a little bit easier. It definitely makes it way easier to wire in stuff, especially because the battery is here and all my wires and stuff are behind these plastics. So having it kind of at eye and hand level makes it a lot easier than trying to bend all the way down and doing it, you know. So that's a little quick tip. So now what we're doing is mocking up where that button's gonna go, and we're basically just measuring how long we need the wire to basically be to where the battery is right there. Now we just went and cut off a bunch of excess wire for the horn right there, just because they send you a bunch because they don't really know if it's going on like a dirt bike or wherever. So we cut it all off so there's not as much wires to go and tuck underneath or anything like that. So basically we're just kind of routing where the horn button's gonna basically set and wire up with the battery, and where we're gonna go and store all the wires in there. So now in this kit they do send you a little template, basically how to wire everything up and how it's supposed to be. So it's not too hard, especially when you have the directions and stuff. You kind of just apply it to basically putting it on a mini bike. So basically in this kit, those two yellow wires are basically the power for two horns, because this kit actually comes with two horns, and we put one on that bike and we're going to put one on this one. So basically you can just go and cut that extra one because we're only going to be running one horn, not two. So now what we did is we took this white negative line basically, and it's too short to where we kind of need it to be. So we went and stripped it, and we're just going to put some more wire from our assortment that we have and just basically extend it and make it longer so it will be able to be where it needs to be, and I can kind of have it all routed there and it's not just strung out everywhere. So we're going to basically kind of mount this thing up in this general area and probably just hold it there with like a zip tie and make sure it's grounded and connected and everything properly. And we're just kind of shortening the wires just because that's going to be mounted there. My horn is there and my battery is there. We just don't need them so long. So we're just shortening them and kind of seeing where everything's going to sit. So basically now we kind of have stuff tucked in and zip tied where we want it to be, and we shortened the wires where it's going to be just perfect. Now, since I already have the lights installed and my stereo system installed, I already have it coming out to two leads. So basically we're just going to splice this horn in with the lights and the stereo. So once that battery's plugged in, I can use my lights on and off, have my stereo going on or off, and then I can go and press my horn. So basically we're kind of just finishing it up. We're putting some wire loom on the wires just because it looks a little nicer, and it's going to protect them from just the dirt and rocks and stuff that get flung up from this front tire. But as you see, we just kind of tapped into the wiring that I kind of already had that connects this wire, that connects basically everything to the speakers and the light kit. Like I said, check in the description if you want to know basically how to set up all of that. So it's kind of just a plug and play ordeal with the battery and everything. So everything's basically kind of done. We're going to plug it in and we're going to test it. And the one that I have installed on my bike is the low tone one, and my dad has the high tone. I don't think there's really too big of a difference, but we put the high tone one on his because his bike has a longer exhaust pipe and his is a little bit more deeper and stuff. Mine isn't as deep, so that's why I went with the low tone, because mine is higher pitched, and we went with the high tone on his because his is lower pitched, so you can hear him a little bit better. So that's basically kind of what we did with those two speakers that comes in the kit. So as you can see, everything's all installed and connected, so you can kind of see how we routed it and everything. And then it connects to the battery. So basically everything is all connected together and legit. The stereo still works. You turn it on and off, it still works. My lights, the switch is here. As you can see, lights still working and everything. And as you can see, I kind of routed the button to be right here. So it's perfect. It's on the handlebar. And when, you know, I need to use it, just press it. Just like that. And that is basically how you go and wire a horn pretty much on anything. So now we're gonna go out and actually test this little thing. Now, as you guys can see, the horn works 100% of how it, you know, a horn's supposed to work. So it looks sick on this thing, especially with the chrome. It adds a lot of flair, and definitely one of those things that's needed for safety. And as you can see in the video, it works perfectly, and you can totally hear it. So that is basically how to install a horn on a mini bike. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure you guys comment, like, and subscribe, and peace.